Hi everybody, welcome back to the Acne Channel. My name is Felicia and today I have a really exciting video in which I'm going to talk about how skin is being portrayed in the media, how celebrities, when they're on magazine covers or videos or anything like that, most of the time, or you know, 99.9% of the time, they're going to be photoshopped. Like, their skin is going to be flawless. It's going to look airbrushed. It's not really realistic. So we're just gonna be talking about that. It's an ongoing conversation and it never gets old for me, because we continually as a society see photoshopped and edited pictures of celebrities, and that's obviously going to affect what we think of beauty. When we think of beauty, we think of perfection. When we think of perfection, we think of flawlessness, because that's what's being portrayed. And it's such a great reminder, and I continuously need to be reminded that, you know, the images that I'm seeing are not real. That's not their real skin texture. A lot of celebrities deal with acne and we wouldn't even know, because all of their photo shoots and videos are edited. So in the spirit of this video, talking about real skin texture and about how we should be embracing our skin, no matter what the texture, no matter what we're going through, like, it's all about just like skin positivity. And I love this type of videos. And in the spirit of that, I'm not wearing any like complexion makeup. I just have my eyebrows done. A lot of people say that, oh, you have perfect skin. Your skin is amazing, it's so smooth. But my reality is, and I know my truth, is that my skin is not perfect. Like, as you can see, even like from this distance from the camera, you know, I had 2 hormonal really big breakouts. I didn't pop them, they naturally just went away, but they left marks. And so now I have like, you know, discoloration on my forehead, and that's fine. There's really nothing I can do. I can't control, you know, like every aspect of my hormones. Sometimes I just have breakouts and that's fine. Life goes on. The world continues to spin, and I take comfort that they're going to go away. And I have residual mild acne scars on the side of my temples here, mostly right here, and also on my cheeks. So, you know, when I go like this, you can kind of see it here. See, like boop, 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 boop. And they're cute. I have no issues with them. I love them. I love that I have real skin and that I have textured skin. And that, yeah, I don't want to portray anything that I'm not. And I definitely don't have perfect skin. You know, it took me a while to own my skin and love my skin. It's also important to remember that your skin is the largest organ in your body. Let that sink in. It's the largest organ in your body. And it's an organ. That means it's continuously functioning to be a gatekeeper. It's doing its job, and the fact that it's doing its job, it means that it's not going to just stay still and be perfect. You know, there's so many moving pieces. It's so complex. And, you know, the fact that we are expected to think that our skin is going to look perfect all the time is mind-blowing to me, because there's going to be a lot of different things, just because your skin is dynamic. It's continuously in the state of change, because that's what it's supposed to do, right? Like, you can't just freeze your skin and be like, stay like this forever. That's just not realistic. It's going to function the way it's going to function. We need to accept that more. You know, so this video is gonna talk about celebrities who, good and bad, celebrities who, you know, have come out and said like, look, my skin has texture and that's okay. Like, there's a red carpet image that came out a while ago of Rihanna having skin texture. Her skin looks like my skin when I wear makeup. And everybody was like mind blown that, oh my God, Rihanna's skin has texture. Yeah. You know, I always laugh at, magazines where it's like, celebrities are just like us. And I every time I see that, I'm like, we're all human. So of course they're just like us, right? But one of them is Rihanna just having skin texture. And also I remember Riri posting a picture of herself, like a selfie, and there's like, you know, a pimple on her chin. And she was just saying how, you know, just leave the pimple alone. It's time to shine or something like that. And I really love that because, yeah, I mean, we all have breakouts. I have breakouts on my chin, on my temples, on my cheeks, on my forehead. I mean, you name it. And people were commenting like, what? Oh my gosh, like there's a blemish on your skin. You know, celebrities should not be expected to have perfect skin. And if we want to break that cycle, stop portraying them to have perfect skin. Like, show us your real skin. So that was a really cool moment. Another one that I remember is Lorde, the singer. So I've read from multiple, like, you know, magazines and articles that she has struggled with acne for a while, and it's like severe acne, and she's, you know, she's a singer, so she has a lot of resources at her disposal, and I'm sure she's tried so many different things, like expensive procedures, you know, vitamins and treatments and, you know, cleansers, moisturizers, everything. And I recently read that, you know, she's done all of that stuff, and it's annoying when someone's like, have you tried moisturizing your skin? You know, you just wanna like, ugh. Horrible. Yeah, it's annoying. So yes, and also what's cool was that, you know, Lorde was at a concert or performing somewhere, and she posted, you know, one, it's the same performance, same day, one picture is edited, one is not, and she's like, stop photoshopping my acne. And I felt like that was so cool. And so like, yes, Lorde, thank you for saying something, because it perpetuates this unrealistic, you know, standard of beauty. And of course, another celebrity that always gets brought up, it's so hard not to talk about her when this topic is brought up, like, you know, skin texture, celebrities, Photoshop, media. You can't not talk about Kendall Jenner. There are just so many photos out there at, you know, red carpets, other famous events, you know, that she goes to, where unedited paparazzi pictures are, you know, leaked, or I don't even know what the terminology is, but you see that she has acne, and you see her residual acne scars, like on her chin predominantly. And, you know, for the longest time, I guess it was hidden. Like, I didn't know she struggled with acne until those pictures came up. But I think when she was doing like a campaign for something like Proactiv, I'm not quite sure, so I may be wrong, don't quote me on it, but I do remember her saying how she's been struggling with acne since high school. She said like every time she got dropped off for school, she would ask her sister Kylie, how does my skin look? Does my skin look better? And Kylie would just be like, yeah, and, you know, would lie to her, essentially. Keke Palmer is like everything. She's goals. I love her so much. I love her personality. I love her confidence. She has PCOS, which is polycystic ovary syndrome. And she, you know, has opened up about how that has perpetuated her acne and made it worse. And yeah, she would post like real skin, like, you know, her acne and everything like that. And I never felt like she's tried to hide it before. She's very open to it. And I love seeing that because, like I said, it's a great reminder. And we need to be reminded all the time because we see unrealistic images all the time. So, you know, needs to like combat that, you know. As many times as we're seeing edited Photoshop photos of celebrities, we need to be just as many times be reminded that it's not real, and that we need examples from, you know, celebrities, influencers, and that stuff to show like, this is my real skin, and I'm in the media, and, you know, I want to be authentic and genuine, and this is what my skin is going through right now. So I love her. There's so many other celebrities that I can think of right now that has acne, like Justin Bieber. I'm sure that you can find a Photoshop photo of Justin Bieber's acne getting edited out. You know, it continues. It's a problem. So it's good that we're continuously talking about it. And yeah, I think that's it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time.